Hi, Naveen here. Today we are going to discuss about the new chapter that is we are calling by the name Money and Credit. So, day-to-day life, for example, if you are going to, a small example I will take, all likes chocolate, right? Yeah. If you are going to shop to buy a chocolate, what will you give? Yes, it is none other than money you are going to give. Okay, fine. How the money has emerged? Is money was when the human being started to live on earth. Is it was there or not? And how was the life without money? What were the difficulties were faced by the men to have to buy a goods or the things? So let's we discuss here. So my topic I am going to talk about money as a medium of, so I am going to talk about money as a medium of exchange. So we can talk here, tell here about here that the money what we are using, exchange mode of exchange also we can say. So the use of money spans a very large part of our daily life, isn't it? When we are saying that is the money what we are using day to day life, it is a very large in our life. When we are seeing our this one around of us, it is able to identify several transactions involving money in a single day. For example, I already said for to buy a chocolate, or to buy a dresses, or to buy a things. Similarly, so to buy a dresses or something is day-to-day life, we are seeing money value. In many these transactions, goods are being brought and sold with use of money, right? So when we are seeing the goods what we are selling, that is the with the use of money. In the sum of these transactions, service also being exchanged with money. For example, how it is a service? For example, if you are going to bank, you are depositing the money or you are withdrawing the money or something else, directly or indirectly you are the service will be given, or else the gas cylinder you are to buy, on that time the service from the what the vendor is giving, that you have to pay money, or doctor services and all. So for a sum, there might be not be any actual transfer of money taking place now, but promise to pay money later. If you don't have the money and all those things, they will be say that I think I don't have that money, and we can take a credit of that. So have you wondered why transactions are made money? The reason is very simple. Why we are making them, our transaction has made up only with the money, as the reason is very simple. The person holding money can easily exchange. What is the use of the money here? A person holding money can easily exchange it for any commodity or services that he or she might want. See here, when I'm seeing the things, wants are unlimited. Okay, if I have a bike, my aim is to take a car or something else. So when I am having the wants, so for wants, what I want, so I can purchase the things or something else to on behalf of a, I will transfer the money to them. Okay, so thus everyone prefers to receive payments in money than exchange of money for things or they want. Take the case shoe manufacturer. He want to sell his shoe in the market and buy a wheat. So it is very example, shoemaker, he want to sell his shoes and he wants wheat. So he wants wheat means what they will do? So he will sell the shoe for money, and what are the money he is getting from there? That he is getting a wheat. The shoe manufacturer will first exchange shoe that he has produced for money and then exchange money for wheat. Okay, imagine how much more difficult it would be the shoe manufacturer had to pay directly exchange shoe for wheat without use of money. So the thing is now to thinking for your capacity, and you have to start to think. If there is no money, so shoemaker needs wheat. So he has to search it now, who is having wheat, and that person needs the shoe. So he would look at the for wheat growing farmer who wants to sell wheat but also wants to buy shoe in exchange. That is, both the parties has to agree for it, right? So that is we are calling that agree to sell by each other commodity. This is we are calling as a double coincidence of wants. What do you mean by the double coincidence of wants in here means, so the for example, shoemaker has to search a farmer who is growing a wheat, and same time he has to search that person needs shoe or not. So it is a little bit difficult, but it is a we are calling by the double coincidence of wants, means both wants are same thing. What a person desire to sell exactly, what other wishes to buy. It is, we are calling as a barter system of exchange. So, what is a barter system is in here means, that's where the goods are directly exchanged without use of money. So, the goods what they are having, they are wishing. So, that is the exchange of the commodities here. That is, we are calling as a barter system of exchange. In the barter system of exchange, make sure that there was no money, but the exchange of goods were there. So that and double coincidence of wants is an essential feature. What is the one features? What is the we can see here about the barter system of exchange? That is a double coincidence of wants. Okay. In contrast, we can tell in economy where money is in use, money buying providing the crucial intermediate step elements, the need for double coincidence of wants. It is not longer necessary for the shoe manufacturer to give farmer who will buy his shoe, and at the same time he has to sell him wheat. So when the money is there, so it's not necessary, right? So what is the things he not able to research the farmers and all those things, so he can exchange with the money. So it all has to be, all has to do find buyer for his shoes. Once has exchanged the shoes for money, he can purchase wheat or any other commodity in the market. Since the money act as an intermediate in the exchange of process, that is we are calling as a medium of exchange. Why money is calling as a medium of exchange means money act as an intermediate. It acts an intermediate in the exchange of process. That is the call we are calling as a medium of exchange. And next classes I am going to teach you about modern forms of money. Up to this, stay tuned to GJS. Thank you. Have a great day ahead.